being here. If we were two people, or 4, 40, or 400, it would be powerful, because we would stand as a people, all wishing for hope, for love, for justice, all of these things that you have written and have in your heart. I'd like for you now to place your palms upward. We all need the strength. We ask for the love of each other and the love of God, Yahweh. We ask for all of this and say, Amen. Shalom. You know, Vicki here walked with us so strong, and there are children across the ocean, and all of these children grow up with horror all around them. That's all they've known. We stand here together hoping for peace and justice for our children and our children's children.
Okay, thanks, Diane. And now we have another wonderful Dallas Peace Center Peacemaker of the Year and all-around troublemaker, Dallas's favorite activist, Hadi Jawad. Hadi.
Everybody, this is a great day, no? Great day for dissent, great day for democracy, and a great day to be out here in front of the George W. Bush Institute and say that I think we ought to do what was the right thing to do is arrest George Bush.
Yeah!
Arrest George Bush!
Arrest George Bush!
I just want the folks to know that we're going to be here next year when the Institute and Library officially opens and the entire world media and the national media will be here, and we are going to be here to let the world know that this is not a library, but rather a library. L-I-E-B-U-R-Y. This is going to be a place where they're going to bury all their lies. But we know, the people know, because we talked about this administration and its plans about Iraq even before the Iraq war started. As we were organizing this event, I was thinking, you know, how do we mark this date? Tomorrow is going to be the 9th year anniversary of the invasion of and the destruction of Iraq. And several thoughts came to my mind, and Leslie and I talked about this. And so I just want to share with you some of the thoughts I had. Many of us have been doing this anti-war work for a long time. But before I go there, let me just take a quick poll of who all we have here as far as groups are concerned. So, can we hear for Occupy Dallas?
Yeah!
Oh my goodness. What a blessing Occupy Dallas has been, and the Occupy Wall Street movement has been to the country, to the nation, and indeed to the entire world. So thank you, Occupy Dallas. We have folks from the Dallas Peace Center. Dallas Peace Center, all right. We have folks from, and you can belong to multiple organizations if you want. How about Code Pink? Pink. And we have some vet, Pax Christi, Joy Saul. And we have some folks all the way from Denton, Texas. Denton, Texas is here, all right. And we have some folks from Tyler, Texas. All right. So who am I missing? Which groups?
Farmersville, Texas!
Hey!
We have, of course, our brothers from Drums Not Guns.
Yes.
Move on,
yeah.
Texarkana is here. How about that? And we have Veterans for Peace.
Hey!
Veterans for Peace. How about that? So now we're
move on.
MoveOn.org is here.
Yes, move on.
What great work MoveOn has done for so many years now. So as I was thinking about, you know, what to call this day, the first thing that came to my mind was Day of Remembrance. Because we have to remember what happened 9 years ago, what has happened to Iraq, and what has happened to Afghanistan, what has happened to my native country where I grew up, to Pakistan. We have to remember the folks who have lost their lives in Iraq. Some estimates indicate that maybe as many as 1 million people, 1 million Iraqi civilians died. Now that's out of a country of 25 million people. If you extrapolate that to the US population, that would be how many times? 8 times? 12 times? That'd be 12 million people dead. We have 5,000 American soldiers who lost their lives in this illegal and immoral and the sad thing is absolutely unnecessary war. There were many of us in Dallas who were telling the US government, there were many folks around the country and around the world, that there aren't any weapons of mass destruction in Iraq. There aren't any. You know, people like us on the streets were saying that. Because there were people who were telling us information, people who were credible. We had UN inspectors, a man named Scott Ritter, a Republican Marine. No lightweight, you know, was saying that, look, I have inspected Iraq's factories, I've been all over Iraq, there aren't any weapons of mass destruction. We had Dennis Halliday, who was the United Nations representative in Iraq at that time, the top man, the chief guy from the UN, who resigned from the UN saying, look, what you are trying to do to Iraq is unconscionable. Don't do this. There aren't any weapons of mass destruction in Iraq. And we knew that. Iraq was a nation because we were following the what was happening in Iraq. Iraq was a nation that was on its knees because of the sanctions that had been instigated and imposed and backed by the US. Iraq was a country of children, and the children were dying at the rate of 5,000 children under the age of 5 every month. And this nation was supposed to represent a threat, an existential threat to the safety and security of the United States. It was mind-boggling to those of us who were on the streets crying. And today, the same people, the same criminals who gave us the Iraq War are talking about a war against the noble people of Iran. The same people are beating the drums of war again. And we say to them that we have seen your lies, you have been exposed, you have platform on CNN and Fox and this and that, but we, the people of this country, reject you, we reject your notions, and we say, no war in Iran!
No war in Iran!
No war!
No war!
No war in Iran!
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 No war in Iran! Middle East. Have you gone totally crazy? Are you insane? Do you know what the consequences of this war could be? Iraq is a nation on its knees, as I said earlier. Iran is the power, it's a regional power. It's 6 times the population of Iraq. So all of the casualties, we lost $4 trillion in Iraq, $4 trillion. $4 trillion. You can multiply that times 6. We lost 5,000 soldiers in Iraq. We lost 1 million Iraqis. You can multiply that by 6. This is insanity. It's diabolical. And those who talk about a war in Iran and the Middle East. They're crazy. And The only way they're going to listen is when people like us, people like you and me will say that we are not going to tolerate it anymore. We have to exit Afghanistan. That's a day of remembrance for us. It's a day of shame too. You know, just like Abu Ghraib was a day of shame for us as Americans. The torture, the humiliation of the Iraqi nation in that prison. And just last week, 16 innocent people were sleeping in their homes. The people of Afghanistan is like the number three, number four nation at the bottom. It's a dirt poor nation, dirt poor. $2 a day is, I think, they make $500-$600 a year. It's a dirt poor nation. And this soldier, who I don't want to demonize, because it reflects overall policy. It has always been a racist war. The war against Iraq was always a racist war. The war in Afghanistan, again, is a racist war. The war against the villagers, the dirt poor villagers of Pakistan, in these horrific and diabolical drone attacks, is a racist war. Racism is part and parcel of this war that we are waging. 10% of Muslim land and Muslim people are living under occupation. 10%. It's racism. It's racism at its finest. We have to leave Afghanistan, and we have to leave now. U.S. troops should leave Afghanistan now. Getting up in the middle of the night, assassinating innocent, dirt-poor villagers. 16 people, there were 9 children. 9 children, one as old as 2 years old. They shoot them and kill them, and then they burn their bodies. What is this? Are we animals? They're human beings. The situation in Palestine, it's a racist war. People driven out of their homes. People driven out of their communities. They've been treated like animals. Gaza is a huge prison in which 4 million people live. It's a compound. Exits are controlled, entries controlled. Everything goes inside is controlled. It's an open air prison. People are being treated like animals. And most of all, let us stop the war on the poor people in the United States. Stop the war against these people. There are 50 million Americans living below the poverty line in the United States. 20 million of these people are living in extreme poverty. Extreme poverty. Out of those 20 million, 8 million are children. Let's stop these insane wars in the Middle East. Bring our troops home. Bring our dollars home. And take care of our home. Thank you for being here. One more time. No war in Iran!
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 All right.
Thank you, Hadi. Okay, to lighten things up a little bit, we'd like to have the not quite ready for prime time activist singers come up here. Not quite ready for prime time activists.
All right.
No rehearsed. That is not rehearsed.
This is great. This is great.
This is great. Microphone. Carol, I don't see you. Where's Carol? Carol can sing loud. Carol, come here. You can sing loud.
It's God Help America, and it's to the tune to God Bless America.
Okay. There you go. All right. Thanks. Okay, ready?
God Help America. We need you bad, 'cause our leaders are cheaters, and they're making the world really mad.
Woo!
mountains, climbing oceans, and invading foreign soil.
Let me introduce from Iraq, Veterans Against the War and Veterans for Peace, Robert Bell.
All right.
I'm about to run out of battery. He's got battery. I'm about to run. My film's about to run out of battery.
What kind of battery?
Good afternoon, everyone.
Camera battery or just?
How's everybody doing?
Not
today?
Eddie's army.
Hey. Wow. So, like Leslie said, I'm an Iraq War veteran. I served two tours in Iraq. I'm here today to speak about the times that we sit on the, Thank you. I'm here today to speak about the times that we stand out on these roads and watch the people go by. And you see the expressions on their face, and they look at us, and you can literally read the thoughts in their minds as, who do they think they are? You know, who do they think they are speaking out? And I'm here today to tell you that we are the husbands and wives who bought the homes that eventually fell from underneath us, and we're stuck with them. We are the mothers and fathers who send our children to the schools that are broken and don't work anymore. We are the sons and daughters who care for our loved ones who can't afford to and sacrifice everything we have left in order to provide for them like they once provided for us. We are the men and women who fight their useless, endless wars. That's who we are. And that's why we stand on the side of the road or in front of unbuilt institutes and say what we have to say. We are here today because we have seen the face of endless war, and we know it does not work. After 9 years of unfettered aggression, we have gotten nowhere. And we will never get anywhere, and it's about to happen again. And we are here today to make sure that men like Bush, Petraeus, Panetta, and Obama hear us. They do not get a chance. They are not allowed to write history with their single pen. We are the ones who live in these homes, in these broken schools, with this broken healthcare system, and fight their wars. Not them. We are here to make sure that it doesn't happen again. And if we do not speak up now, it will happen again. And we will continue this useless war. Thank you.
Right. Hey. Amen, brother. Amen, brother.
All right. Jonathan is going to play a song for us now. So come on back, Jonathan.
All right.
Okay, I'm going to let you cover it. I'm running out of battery.